This program was first broadcast on Canterbury's community access radio station Plains FM 96.9 and was made with the assistance of New Zealand On Air.
It's time for Emergence News on Plains FM 96.9, citizen-made radio.
Hello and welcome to Emergence News, brought to you through Plains FM in Christchurch. We're a group of volunteers bringing information of the emergence of Maitreya and his disciples, the Masters of Wisdom. Following the day of declaration by Maitreya the Christ, the world will be stunned into silence for a while. But then will follow the carrying out of the blueprints which already exist of the divine plan, with sharing the world's resources as top of the list. Nations will be asked to list surplus goods that can be distributed to nations in need, and a new agency of the United Nations will coordinate transport. No longer do we need to produce great surpluses of manufactured goods, such as cars which wait for buyers in their millions on vast parking lots. Perhaps we need trucks to distribute surplus food to desperate nations. With the heart of humanity activated by the Lord of Love himself, compassion will start to play its role and bring sharing and justice to those dispossessed. And so a new chapter in the Earth's history will begin. With me today are Shafia and John. So what are you discussing today, Shafia?
So I'm just talking a little bit more about what is going to happen after the Day of Declaration, what we've been told will happen, and yes. Just,
that sounds great. And yeah. John, what about you?
I'll be following on a similar theme to Shafia, and we'll sort of banter around a few ideas and see what we can come up with.
Sounds
great.
Both
been researching Benjamin Creme, I guess.
Excellent. That'll be great.
Thank you, Peter. In our last program, we talked about the Day of Declaration, which we often call the Day of Days. It really will be the first day of the rest of our lives when Maitreya, the great Lord of Love, will declare himself openly and finally be seen to be living among us. I meet many people at different expos that we attend who have known about this story for many years and come and ask if there are any developments and when will he be here and when will it all happen. So we tell them, well, he's already here, living and working among us, inspiring movements and changes that will be the foundation of a new world. For those of us who tell the story, we see his influence and that of the Masters of Wisdom in the many grassroots movements which promote and practice sharing, sustainability, regeneration, technical advances, and scientific breakthroughs. We see it in the passion and the purpose of the young people who are becoming the leaders of this new time. They might not personally know about Maitreya, but they declare his teachings and are taking the action that he is calling us all to make. As he has said, he can be the architect of this new world, but we all have to create it with our effort and actions. So what can we expect to see once the Day of Days has happened? We have touched on a few changes, but there is lots more that we can look forward to. Some might not sound too appealing in the present moment as we are caught up in what is presently normal and familiar. But I'm sure when the time comes, we will recognise how much richer and interesting our lives have become. As we have said, the most immediate priority will be the feeding of the world. This will happen by each individual country sharing with the global community all their excess resources. It is estimated that it will take approximately 3 years to have all the systems in place and everyone experiencing food security, many for the first time in their lives. One of the most important aspects of this achievement will be the collective letting go of the guilt and distress that the majority of us feel, seeing and knowing that there are people starving in this abundant world and feeling helpless to change it. Food security for all will release a tremendous creative energy that will be channeled into beautifying our world and discovering new wonders. Instead of watching reality shows, we will be able to see every day what different countries and cultures are doing to improve their lives. We'll be inspired and encouraged rather than living vicariously through the trials and troubles and dramas of others. I'm looking forward to that. you guys, when we're actually seeing what people are doing, you know, with this new energy and this new vitality that they'll have.
That's not too far away either.
And it's going to create, there's so much creativity that's latent in people.
Yes.
And will be stimulated by this very fact of, you know, people having enough food to eat.
And it's suppressed by this philosophy of commercialization. Mm-hmm. Creativity is actually suppressed
by our
economic management of the planet.
That's right, So alongside the sharing of resources, we'll be needing to address the needs of our Earth and stabilise the environment we live in. We will come to recognise that we can no longer consume at the rate we are now. This means that the high street we know will probably change dramatically. Shopping malls will probably become redundant, and no longer will market forces, speculation, retail indexes and GDP growth be relevant. With the technological advances, many jobs will become redundant too. So people will have far more leisure time. Maitreya promises that no 2 days will be alike. The hamster wheel we have been on will finally stop spinning, and we'll be able to follow our passions and become the creators we truly are. So instead of going to the mall and shopping for things that have been produced in sweatshops by people on the other side of the world who are paid a pittance, we will be able to obtain beautifully made items through some form of exchange system that will replace our present money system. I know so many folks who would just love to create and share for the pure joy of it rather than having to worry about selling their gifts, be it healing skills or beautifully made items or their skill in the arts, just to survive. There have been so many anthems on the theme of freedom over the years. We all long to be free to be who we are. This coming new golden age will finally see us achieve this freedom. So what would you two do when, if you didn't have to work?
I would do much more around Maitreya and his ideas and his philosophies.
Mm-hmm.
You guys would see a lot more of me.
Yes.
You know, which could be problematic, I guess. I would spend a lot more time keeping healthy.
Mm.
So doing things that had a wellness focus. Mm. And I would spend more time with friends.
Yes.
So I've actually got a list of things that I could do. I'd be gainfully unemployed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it would only take a week and I'd be completely unemployable. My attitude would have changed so much.
Good one.
It would be amazing. What about you, Peter?
Well, I think, I'd like to catch up on some of the reading that I've put on the back burner over these years. But we do know quite a bit about the esoteric philosophy. Well, we're beginners, but... you know, I'm sure a lot of people want to know, even at the level that we know, that some of the stuff that has been spoken about and we've known about for most of our lives, following the ancient wisdom teachings.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, just for people to realize that their souls and incarnation is like a breakthrough for some people, they have no idea about this at all.
Yes, quite.
What would you do, Shafia?
I would probably be the same as you, because, I mean, this is what we're training for now, aren't we, really? Mm. Would be helping to spread the knowledge and, you know, but I would like to do more, you know, to have more time to actually do some creative arts, that sort of, to actually learn to use my fingers more. I'd love to learn to be a carpenter, actually. I've always wanted to work with wood. And so that's, you know, I don't really have the time for those sort of things. You're doing mosaics or, you know, that sort of.
It's interesting, this commercial model. I was in a rather large shopping mall on the weekend with about 60,000 other people, and I used two of the shops, one for groceries and one to replace a pair of shoes that had worn out.
Yeah.
The rest of that shopping mall had nothing for me.
No.
I found that quite an interesting exercise.
Yes, yeah, definitely. I mean, we're just smothered with choice and we don't need it at all.
No, baubles for magpies.
Yes, yes, definitely. So we're told that Maitreya will visit every country in the world. He's the world teacher and is here for each and every one of us. He'll introduce us to his group of masters who will become well known and will take up positions of guidance and teaching. The most famous master is, of course, the Master Jesus, who presently resides just outside Rome. He will become the leader of the Christian world and guide it back to its original teachings. Religions will remain and be reformed in the light of the new teachings that will be available to all. People, if they wish, will be able to study and learn for entry into the mystery schools that will be established around the world. We are told that there are millions ready to take the first initiation. which, if you have listened to previous programs featuring initiation, you will know is the birth of the Christ energy within the heart of humanity and represented for us by the birth of Christ in Bethlehem. All these souls in human form will come before Maitreya to receive the rod of initiation and begin their journey into learning and assimilating the great mysteries. Of course, alongside all this will be resistance by those who see their power and privilege being undermined. It will take a period of adjustment for people to accept that we are all equal and deserving of food security, a home to live in, and free healthcare and education for all. We have known and acknowledged this for 70 years when it was written out in the Declaration of Human Rights. This document is a testament to the higher aspirations of humanity. The fact that it has not been implemented is due to the lack of political will to create the conditions and the institutions to enable these principles to become a reality. Therefore, a form of social democracy for the people and by the people will replace our present political institutions. So transport will be another major change in our lives. At the moment, many who are becoming socially and spiritually aware feel the impact of our travelling, whether it be by car or plane. Many are trying to limit their use of these polluting activities in a personal effort to do their bit for the environment. The good news is that once we have taken responsibility for our planet, we will be given access to free energy that will transform our ability to travel anywhere we wish without affecting ourselves or the planet. It is our right to travel and see other cultures and ways of being. Rather than becoming one homogenous mix, we will celebrate diversity whilst being aware of our unity as one human family. The often quoted phrase, unity in diversity, will become a reality, and no longer will travelling to other countries be confined to those who can afford it. Not only that, we'll have the time to do it. Fair Bring goodness. It on, eh?
Soon.
Yes.
Well, thanks, guys. And this is kind of interesting stuff, isn't it? Because it's science fiction actually coming real. Because in all the science fiction books and movies I've seen, no one works.
Yes.
How silly. No. Why would we work?
No, they've got robots in the factories, haven't they?
Exactly.
Doing everything.
And we don't want to be doing that to humans. We don't want to be turning humans into robots.
No.
I think there's a couple of other things that I'd like to kind of whet people's appetite with. And, of course, everything we've talked about is available in the Share International magazine, Benjamin Creme's books. Healthcare after this day of declaration. What are we going to do for healthcare? And Creme has talked about the science of vibration, and that takes the form of light and colour therapy. Mm-hmm. He's also talked about the body's inherent ability to regenerate itself. He's also talked about that one of the biggest killers on the planet is stress, generated by this unnatural life that we have created for ourselves, and driven by these forces of materialism, these forces of consumerism. So that once we release ourselves from the shackle of that slavery, I think we're going to see some great changes in health anyway. Mm-hmm. But Creme has talked about vibration and the use of colour and light as part of our healing process. And, of course, we have Te Clote Water, so the healing waters, which are a bridge between our current healing processes and the new things that will come to us once we've accepted Maitreya's direction. Mm-hmm. Bearing in mind that Maitreya is still offering us our free will and will show us the way, and it'll be up to us to pick ourselves up and go in a new direction. Mm. The other thing that Creme has talked about is this technology of light, and he's talked about it being free and infinite. And we know that it's being worked on already on this planet. We also know that the Space Brothers have a role in that technology. And I guess if I think about what my salary goes to per annum, the buying of energy in various sources is a big cost to me.
Yes, definitely.
And if I can get all the energy that I need to run my house and my lifestyle, and it's free, then my need to work changes drastically. So what Maitreya is saying is once we play nice with each other, once we learn sharing, once we learn to understand our relationship, then the Space Brothers will release to us some of these technologies. You don't get the really good stuff until you really start behaving yourself, is the message I'm hearing.
Giving up war.
Giving up war, for instance. Imagine if we had free and infinite energy thrown into this political economic mix at the moment. There would be a world war to control it, to patent it, to steal it, to hold on to it. So until we can learn to treat each other well, we won't get exposed to some of these great ideas. A lot of these great ideas are coming from the Space Brothers. And certainly that concept of Space Brothers was the thing that I struggled with the most when I encountered the Benjamin Creme story about Maitreya. But what he said is we live in a benign, intelligent, respectful solar system. We are one of the non-sacred planets, and that we are being assisted as much as we can on our evolutionary process by the Space Brothers. But once Maitreya has declared himself and once we start moving in the right direction, Maitreya will explain to us humanity's relationship and history with the other beings that inhabit the solar system. And once we become aware of that, we will start to be introduced to the Space Brothers and the technology and lifestyle that they can present for us and assist us with. So really, humanity's at this tipping point. We've almost damaged the planet. We're damaging each other at an alarming rate. Our lifestyle's not sustainable economically, environmentally, mentally, or emotionally, or physically. And when Maitreya steps forward and we accept his ideas, then we will be open to a whole lot of other new ways to do things. And I'm looking forward to not having to work. And I hope that you guys are looking forward to seeing more of me.
Yes, definitely, John.
I don't know if I heard yes from you, Peter.
Oh, we'll go along with that, John.
So from my understanding, every planet on this in this solar system is actually inhabited, so we're told.
Yes. And I guess both Peter and I have discussed this previously. We live in this confederation of the solar system, if you like, and we live in a lovely street called the solar system, but we're the junkyard neighbours. You know, we're the ones with the open fire spewing pollution out into the street. We're the ones with rusting wrecks of cars on the front lawn and pit bull dogs barking at everybody as they walk past. And it's our section in this lovely street that's quite messy. And that has an effect on the rest of the solar system. So the Space Brothers are representatives of those various planets, are assisting us as much as they can within the outlines of free will and our own karmic perspective to evolve and help with our evolution and help with some of the issues that we are addressing. And that phenomenon of UFO Space Brothers being seen around nuclear disaster sites or back in the 60s nuclear silos was actually a thing because they've been involved for a long time in helping us manage something that we don't understand, and that is radiation. And we've been producing huge amounts of radiation, spewing it out into space and damaging our health and the life of the planet. So the Space Brothers, for instance, have been involved in helping us manage behind the scenes our misunderstanding of radiation. Creme has also said that the Space Brothers have produced a web of energy lines around the planet that will enable us to move into this ability to use the technology of light.
The crop circles are part of this.
Crop circles. Fantastic things.
Amazing. Yes, yeah. I always wonder that people aren't so much more curious about them.
No. And those two guys that were supposedly making them have long since died.
Duncan and Dave.
And, you know, they had a board with a couple of ropes and they were crushing the stalks. And actually, if you do some more research around the crop circles, the crops are not damaged anyway. They're bent over at the ground. There's an energy around the crop circles.
And inside.
The plants grow particularly well. And there's a whole lot of really intelligence gone into that design that we are failing to appreciate.
Yeah. Mm.
And it's our good neighbours are knocking on the door and saying, hey, we're here.
Mm. Yes,
we're here to help. Just ask us.
Mm.
And we're going, either we don't know who you are or you're evil and you want to come and snatch our bodies.
Mm. Well, we've been programmed for that, haven't we?
Yes, and that's that awful imagery that we've been fed over the years. And I've been a fan of science fiction for a long time. That paints the other as the baddie.
Yes.
He's evil because he's not like us. Well, actually, he's probably more evolved than we are. He's able to trip around the solar system effortlessly, and we have a lot to learn from our space brothers.
Mm-hmm. We do. I think there's a big disclosure project going on at the moment, actually. I mean, I noticed that a lot of pilots and astronauts are coming out and saying they've seen these UFOs and people talking about it more. So there, there is it's the knowledge is coming out. I think maybe it's preparing us for when we actually really meet them for the first time.
Look, and I think also, Shafia, that some of the technology you talked about, the ability to travel easily and comfortably, some of those things, this technology that really will be shared with us from the Space Brothers, from this benign, intelligent confederation that we will become part of, that stuff will start to unfold.
Yes.
But literally you cannot give children really destructive or potentially destructive technology if they can't behave themselves. So that message about let's get on together, let's consider planet Earth a spaceship with, instead of 195 nations, 195 crew members. How are we all getting on together? How are we managing this spaceship? Are we doing well? No, not really.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to get that level of agreement and relationship and trust so that we can manage the planet as one unit, as one people. And then we will be exposed to what the rest of the solar system can offer us.
Indeed, I think you're right, Tom. This is the Emergence News on Plains FM. For more information, go to shareinternational.org. This message comes from Maitreya the Christ, and he was overshadowing Benjamin Krem at the time, and he gave 140 messages in total. So this is number 42. Many times have you heard me say that my coming means change. Specifically, the greatest change will be in the hearts and minds of men. For my return among you is a sign that men are ready to receive new life. That new life for men do I bring in abundance. On all planes this life will flow, reaching the hearts and souls and bodies of men, bringing them nearer to the source of life itself. My task will be to challenge these waters of life through you. I am the water carrier. I am the vessel of truth. That truth shall I reveal to you and lift you into your true nature. I am the river. Through me flows the new stream of God-given life, and this shall I bestow on you. Thus shall we together walk through my garden, smell the perfume of my flowers, and know the joy of closeness to God. My friends, these things are not dreams. All this will be yours. My mission will vouchsafe this to you.
All this information can be found on the Share International website, www.share-international.org. Scorpio Books in Christchurch carries the magazine and some books. And also don't forget the podcasts, which are available on the Plains FM website.
We welcome your comments, questions and feedback. Please contact us at emergencenews@gmail.com.
The opportunity to join our transmission is available Monday and Wednesday evenings and Thursday mornings, which gives us the possibility to do a service meditation in conjunction with the Masters.